Come all you maids and you very pretty maids, and one in take be me, don't go down to the chaser's wood. If a maid you want to return, and return. If a maid you want to return. Lady Margaret, Lady Margaret, she was sitting in her bower. She was red as any rose, but she longed to go to the chaser's wood, to pull them flowers that grows and that grows. I to pull them flowers that grows. So she's picked up her silver comb, made haste to comb her hair, and ain't she away to the chaser's wood, as fast as she could tear and could tear. Aye, as fast as she could tear. But she hadn't pulled nor the one red rose, the rose that grows there in the green, when a voice said, Lady, how dare you pull a rose without no leave of me, nor of me. No, without no leave of me. She says, this little wood, why, it is me very own. 'Twas me father, he give it to me. I shall pull, pluck, break, or bend any bough, and I shan't ask leave of thee, nor of thee. No, I shan't ask leave of thee. So he's taken her by the lily-white hand, down to where the grass is green. And what they'd done, well, I just couldn't say, for the green grass grew between. Aye, the green grass grew between. And it's taken her by the middle so small, down to where the grass is green. And what they'd done, well, I just couldn't say, but he never once asked her leave. No, he never once asked her leave. Well, there's 24 maidens, they're all sitting in the hall, and they're playing at the chess, all excepting young Margaret. She's green as any grass, and she's as green as any grass. Then up then spoke one of them little girls, and on her face there was a smile. She says, I think me lady's loved a little long, and now she goes with child and with child. And now she goes with child. And up there spoke another of them girls. Pretty little girl was she. She says, I know of a herb growing in the chaser's wood, as'll twine the babe from thee and from thee. As'll twine the babe from thee. So she's picked up her silver comb, made haste to comb her hair, and ain't she away to the chaser's wood, as fast as she could tear and could tear. As fast as she could tear. But she hadn't pulled nor the one bit of hair, the hair that grows there in the loam, when out there steps young Tam Lin. Margaret, leave it alone now, sweetheart, Margaret, leave it alone. And it's why do you pull that bitter, bitter hair? The hand that grows there so grey, it's all to twine away that pretty little baby. We got in our play,
we got in our play.
Well then tell me this, young Tam Lin, she said, if a mortal man you be. He says, I'll tell you the truth, not a word of a lie. I was christened as good as thee and as thee.
I was christened as good as thee.
But as I rode out on a bitter, bitter day, it was from me horse I fell, and the queen, the elvins did take me. In yon greenwood for to dwell and to dwell.
In yon greenwood for to dwell.
And it's every seventh year we pay a toll to hell. The last one in is the first to go, and I fear that toll's myself, I myself. I fear that's all to myself. For tonight it is the Halloween, when the elven coach will ride, and if you would your true lover save, by the old mill bridge you must hide, you must hide.
By the old mill bridge you must hide.
And it's first will come this black horse I, and then there'll come the brown. They'll be both raised by the white. You must throw your arms up around my neck. I'll not you a fright, nor a fright.
I'll not you a fright.
And the wood grew dark, and the woods grew dim. Tam Lin was gone, she's picked up her lily white feet, and to the mill bridge run, now she's run. And
to the mill bridge run.
And she's looked high and she's looked low, she has compassed all around, but she nothing heard and she nothing saw. She heard no mortal sound, no sound.
No, she heard no mortal sound.
Till about the dead hour of the night, she's heard them bridles ring light. Chilled her heart, it's given her a start, more than any mortal thing, anything.
More than any mortal thing.
And it's first there came this black horse eye, and then there came the brown. They were both raised by the white. She's thrown her arms up around his neck. He didn't have a fright, nor a fright.
He didn't have a fright.
Then the thunder rolled across the sky, and lightning crashed like day, and the queen of the elvins gave a trilling cry. Tam Lin, he's away, he's away.
Tam Lin, he's away.
So they changed him then, it was all in her arms, to a lion roaring wild, but she's held him tight and she feared him not. The father of her child, she knew he was
the father of her child.
So they changed him again, it was all in her arms, to a big black hissing snake, but she's held him tight and she's feared him not. He was one of God's own make, she knew he was one of God's own make. So they changed him again, it was all in a round, to a big black dog to bite, but she held him tight and she feared him not. He didn't have a fright, nor a fright. He didn't have a fright. So they changed him again, all in a round, to a white hot bar of iron, but she held him tight and she feared him not. He done to her no harm, no harm. No, he done to her no harm. So they changed him then, it was all in a round, to a mother naked man. She's thrown a cloak up around his neck, saying, Tam Lin, oh, we've won, oh, we've won. Then how the Queen of the Elvins, didn't she curse young Tam Lin? Oh, how she's cursed him good. She said, I should have took out your eyes, young Tam Lin. I should have put into eyes of wood, eye of wood. I should have put into eyes of wood. And its curses on you, Tam Lin, she said. You once was me very own, and when you was, I should have torn out your heart. I should have put in the heart of stone, cold stone. I should have put in the heart of stone.